guys, Henry here from IFE. So today I want to talk about why I'm going to include Fundsmith Emerging Market Equity Trust, or the FEET Fund, in my personal portfolio. Many of you may have heard of the Fundsmith name, Terry Smith, very popular, the Fundsmith, especially if you're a UK listener, you would have come across Fundsmith. It is the UK's, or one of the UK's, largest funds, and it's done extremely well over the past decade. The Emerging Market Fund, though, has not done particularly well on a performance side and is very small in comparison, with around 312 million under management compared to Fundsmith's 24 billion, I think it's currently holding. Some of the reasons, like I said, why it is underrated or not as well funded is it hasn't outperformed the emerging markets over the last 4 or 5 years. It's had larger downfalls and the gains haven't been significant. So why am I including it in my personal portfolio, and why you may want to have a look at it? Firstly, it's very different to a lot of the emerging markets indexes, and also the emerging market funds that are currently in place. Now, when I go look around the emerging market for funds or in stocks, I find a lot of the same components working in their way. They're mainly large cap Chinese companies, Tencent, Alibaba, JD, Ping An Insurance, just to name a few. Now, it does hold a few of these, Tencent here, Taiwan Semiconductor as well, it's Taiwanese obviously, but it also has a more of a diversification to India. Now, it's Indian companies that are consumer supplies, like Nestle India, and that work with the larger companies, consumer supplies like Unilever, Reckitt Benckiser, and the ideology is that these companies are going to grow in time with the GDP of the country. Also in the fund, it has Vietnamese dairy manufacturers, I think it is, as well. I remember looking at that and just looking at this good stock to hold. So yeah, it's very different to the traditional Chinese emerging markets funds that you'd come across, or any index for that light. Also, it's actually, I think it's a good thing that it's being so poor, because it's with investment trusts, they have the ability to trade below the NAV. So unlike a mutual fund where it's based on the calculation of the share price, an investment trust can actually trade above or below NAV. Now, this is actually trading at quite a low NAV compared to historically, and compared to other NAVs which we've talked about, particularly the Scottish Mortgage Investment Trust, that is trading at quite a high NAV. So I actually think that a lot of speculation has been taken away from this fund. Now, I do think it's going to have volatility in the medium term. It's not a fund that you would even want to hold for 5 years. I think it's more looking 10, 20 years plus. So it's more for the younger investors, or one that wants to pass it over for a generation. I also see it as a good diversification to the large cap equities that you may hold within either a Fundsmith or MSCI World Eye Global Index, or in an index tracker like Vanguard or iShares. So I believe it has got legs in that room. I'm going to do another video, and a few of my reports go over a bit of the fundamentals about it, how it's holding, and we'll touch upon that in a later video. If you do have any questions about the equity fund, feel free to drop me a message at info@investmentforexpats.com. Thanks, guys.